What's up, guys? It's that Italian guy again here, bringing you back another episode of Let's Play Skyrim Special Edition, episode 45. And actually, this is my second time recording this because the first time the commentary was not there for some god awful reason. So we're just redoing this episode. So in the last episode we went through the farmer village like thing that was full of happiness and despair and death. So today we are in the inner sanctum with our homegirl Serana, who is just chilling there, sitting on that bench. And we are gonna go into this temple sanctum area and we're gonna kick some booty. So okay, I really want that, please, thank you. Not gonna explode out of that ice, buddy. Okay, good, stay that way, don't move a muscle. Okay, so I'm going to take that. I'm going to take these gems. I'm going to take that as well, because I don't know when I'm going to need one. Amethyst, that. I'll take these arrows. Touch the shrine. Get all our blessings. And then, what do you have? I really don't need that. I kind of want that, and I know you're going to... Yeah, I knew you were gonna do that. I love, absolutely love how they just break up into pieces like that. It's like if you told them a funny joke, they'd be cracking up. That was terrible. I'm so sorry about that, guys. Cracking up. That was terrible. I'm sorry, guys. That was very terrible of me to say. What's up, giant? I'm gonna slice your booty up. Why am I not shouting? Why? Oh, God. Why am I not shouting? Oh, yeah, that's right. I can't shout in here. Dude. Hey, giant, pick on somebody your own size. And by that, I don't mean me. Oh, my. I guess this is... Oh! Oh my god, that scared the shit out of me. I thought he killed me. I was like, oh no! Oh, that scared me so much. Oh my god, my heart is pounding. Okay, I need to go... I keep forgetting to do this. I need to go grab that that jug again. Because I want to go get what's in that other room! Because there's some good stuff in that room. I mean... There was the first time I went in there, but you never know. There could be some more good stuff. But yeah, what's up, guys? It's Thursday. And I work early today. I work from 6 to 3. And I have to be up at 4 in the morning. I was up at 4 in the morning this morning, guys. But that is A-okay with me because I get off early then. And I have the next 2 days off, even though I have to go to a field trip on Saturday for my environmental studies class, which honestly isn't too bad. I mean, I get to learn in the outdoors. Okay. Serana, where are you? Oh, don't tell me she got stuck in that room. Yep, that's what happened. Yep. Oh, silly Serana. Silly, silly Serana. I don't know if you guys can hear that. My freaking controller goes apeshit when I open these freaking doors and whatnot. Yeah, let's take that. Yeah, it like rumbles really, really a lot. And I don't know if you guys can hear it, but it's kind of annoying. I have to like lift my hands up from my lap to make it stop rumbling. Alright, Serana, get over here. I don't want to trap you. Thank you. Thank you for cooperating. You too, Grim. I'm gonna call him Grim because if you guys ever watched, ooh, I'll take that. The Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy, that was like one of my favorite childhood shows. If you guys ever watch that, you will know what I'm talking about. Alright, what do you got over here? Oh, damn! I'm gonna take that. Looks like they're cracking up too. Honestly, Serana, your freaking skeleton scares me. Because, like, when the skeletons are just standing there or, like, doing anything, their bones, like, creak. And for some reason, when it's, like, standing right behind me, it just... Did you guys see that? It, like, glitched for a second there. That was crazy. What do you got? I don't know if I really want that. I'll take it anyway. Oh, he's not gonna turn. Never mind. No, I was prepared to kill for nothing. Alright, we got nothing else here. Let's just move on. What do you got? Elven war axe? Nah. Nah. Not about that life. Alright. We have to go this way. Yeah, when I recorded this episode the first time, I was really angry because I recorded the whole episode, and mind you, like the idiot I am at times, I forgot to save the game when I got directly into the Inner Sanctum. So I had to start from the Falmer Village area and come all this way again. Which, I mean, didn't take me too long. It took me, like, the better half of 10 minutes or so. But it was the fact that I went so far without even realizing that I was, you know, that I didn't save. And I was just super upset. I was mad. And I'm not going that way because the last time, and you guys won't see it because, you know, that episode's lost, kind of. When I went, nope, never mind, it's doing it anyway. There was a lot of lag coming through here. And it's happening again. It's happening, oh god. Stop with the lag, please. Please. Is that it? Okay, thank you.
Did you really come here expecting to claim Ariel's bow?
Yes, I did. Okay.
Is he talking about me?
Well, while he's kind of talking, I'm going to take him water.
Usefulness is at an end.
Oh, whoops. I guess it doesn't help when I'm drinking water and there are enemies attacking me. I'm sorry, Serana. Oh, I guess I could do the. I could have done this. Oh god, there's a Falmer. Like, ew, why does he look so disgusting? I'm gonna say it again because it was lost in the last time, but shout out to my boy Max for telling me about creating these potions. This potion of resist poison. Honestly, probably would have worked really good in that couple seconds that I was getting bitten by those centipede things, because it'll make it so poison damage does not affect me as much as it normally would. So I'm gonna just take that just in case, and then take another potion. Okay, you need to die. Don't you? Were you about to give me them hands? Oh, fudge nuggets! Fudge nuggets! You're just delaying your death.
Watch out.
Shut up. Yeah, and then he tries to, like, destroy the ceiling, so we gots to be careful. We gots to be careful, because if we get hit, we're kind of screwed. Falmer, you come here. You come here, buddy. Come get these hands. Oh, this sword. How did that not even hit that guy? I slashed his way. Okay, I love how these farmer, even though they're like basically already dead, kind of. It's just like, it's funny that like they're just trying to claw me to death. Oh my god, that big old chunk of roof just fell on top of me and I almost died. Go away, leave me alone. I should probably take advantage of potions of stamina. Okay, you guys are really starting to piss me off. I know you guys can't really tell in my voice because I'm always like really calm and stuff sometimes, but these farmer are really starting to piss me off. God damn. Jesus. Finally. Shut up already. I think it causes a big explosion. And then my freaking controller goes berserk. Serana, save me.
Come on, we can do this. I know we can. He's up there on the balcony. Come on.
Yeah, and naturally we can't pull out our sword because, you know, it's not right when he's just shriveling up right there, dying. And we have a sword, you know. What's up, dude? And I kind of watch his animation a little bit. This is kind of where some of the animation in this game kind of went south a little bit. But you see how when he's talking, he stands up straight. And then he'll like slope down like that because he's injured. Okay, maybe it was just in the recording that I did with no audio. Or no comment. Oh, no, see, he does it. It's like, why make him stand and slope and then stand and slope? It doesn't make sense to me. I don't know. Maybe that's just me being nitpicky like I am sometimes with certain stuff, but, you know, I mean, come on.
Ariel's bow.
The blood of a vampire. Ariel's bow. It was you? You created that prophecy?
A prophecy that lacked a single
plot twist.
Ingredient. The blood of a pure vampire. The blood of a daughter of Cold Harbor.
I've been waiting all this time for
some. Damn, Strana, you got that muscles, girl.
Too bad.
See, under those sleeves of her shirt are 100% pure, unadulterated freaking biceps. And we're just gonna freaking destroy this guy. Because why not? And then he tries to wimp out, and then, never mind. I like how we hit him and then he fucking goes flying. He's just it's like, I'm out of here, but you know. Okay, what's he got on him? Some gems. Oh, cool. I used one of these when I was trying to get here, so I'll take two. And I'll take that. This ancient Falmer armor right here, not gonna lie, is pretty darn cool, so I'm gonna just take it all. I'm gonna take it all. Take it all, okay? What's up, my dude?
So the deed has been done. The restoration of this way shrine means that Werther must be dead, and the betrayed no longer have control over him.
The betrayed are we're not to blame.
What? What are you talking about?
He was a vampire. He controlled them.
A vampire? I see. That would explain much. Deep inside, it brings me joy that the betrayed weren't to blame for what happened here.
Why? Just why?
Because that means there's still hope that they might one day shed their hatred and learn to believe in AURIEL'S once again.
I doubt it.
It's been a long time since I felt that way, and it's been long overdue. My thanks to both of you.
You're welcome.
You risked everything to get AURIEL'S bow, and in turn, you restored the Chantry. I can't think of a more deserving champion to carry it than you. If you wish to learn more about the bow, or obtain Sunhallowed Arrows for it, I'd be more than happy to help. You've but to ask.
Thanks, dude. Look at it. It's so beautiful. So sleek. Yet so rugged and edgy. And to tell you the truth, the whole time, I thought in this necessarily, like, specific moment. Yes, he just wants us to go through there, but we need to talk to Serana first. But, like I was trying to say is, in, like, the whole kind of lore of me playing this game, like, when I first did the Dawnguard DLC, for some reason, I always thought AURIEL'S was a girl, like a goddess, not a god. And I didn't really pay attention enough to the dialogue to actually see that they were calling him a him and not a her and whatnot. So yeah, we need to speak to Serana, but where is she, girl? Where you be? Girl, if you don't get your fine ass over here. Oh, that. Serana, you know the battle's over, right? Girl, I swear to God, if you don't put that hand down. Girl, come on, really? Can I use a shout to just knock her over or something? Oh, thank God. I'm really think force. Oh, great. Look at what you did. Girl, really?
What now?
Wait there. No. Whatever.
If there's any, it's good to speak to you again.
Okay, I don't know. Serana's broken, guys. I think she's broken.
What do you need? What do you need?
Okay, I need you to come all the way over here. What do you mean you can't do that for me?
I don't think so.
Alright, Serana, if you just want to be broken and brain dead right now, go ahead. I'm going home. I went through the wrong portal. I swear to God, if my game crashes because of her. Okay, I was gonna say. No, I don't need to go there. Yeah, portal of temple balcony. That's where I need to go. Oh, finally they're all, you know, working. Alright, Serana, are you not broken anymore? No, you're still broken. All right, we're just gonna go to Fort Dawnguard real quick, cause I know for a fact that's where we need. Actually, you know what? Let's go to the Western Watchtower just to, you know, see if Serana's okay. Cause if she's not okay, we may have a problem here. Houston, we might have a problem. Oh my God, dude. Water is so amazing. Oh, water. Okay, Serana.
It's not as shiny as I was expecting. Still, it's beautiful.
I'm a loss at words because you were broken. You were standing there with your guard up.
It's not as shiny as I was expecting. Still, it's beautiful.
Shut up. What do we do now?
I think we both know. It's time to face my father. If we don't, he'll keep chasing us for the rest of our lives.
If we do, he'll have to die.
I've been thinking about this for a long time. It's not easy. But I don't think we have much of a choice. No. This has to end here and now.
Then let's face him together.
Back to the castle and kick the front door in. We're gonna be knee deep in his friend.
Let's go to Fort Dawnguard now, okay? Okay, wait. Let's just wait for the marker to get off the top of her head. Alright. Oh, I just realized, guys, this video might go up pretty late on today is Tuesday as I'm recording this, and I just realized I've got a lot of stuff going on today that the video is going up Thursday. Today is Thursday when the video is going up, and I have a lot of things to do after work. So this video might go up pretty late, not gonna lie to you guys, it's gonna go up pretty late. I'm sorry it's gonna have to be that way, but I got things to do, and to be honest, I'm so sorry about that, guys. I realized that I had so much stuff to do, but yeah, I'll try my best to get it up as early as possible. Alright, Eastern. We have Ariel's bow. Okay, I'm just gonna skip the text because, really, I've already gone through this once before, and, like, basically all he does, really, is gather all the people that are up in Fort Dawnguard and whatnot, and basically they do this, like, He gives a speech to all the dudes and dudettes, and basically he's just like, oh yeah, we've got what we need to go kill the vampires, and that's basically it. It's kind of underwhelming. Maybe I'll just play it out for you guys, just because it's actually a good speech, I'm not gonna lie. Who are we waiting for? Who are we missing? God! Late to the party, I guess.
We've allowed these vampires to poison the night and kill our people. Now, we finally have the means to strike back. We now have Auriel's bow. The gods themselves have favored us, and we must answer with action. The time has come to finally put an end to Hargon and his unholy prophecy. We will march on their lair and destroy those wretched abominations so they can no longer corrupt our world. This is our fight, and this is our fate. This is the time.
Yeah.
Of the Dawnguard. Kill the abominations!
I like how they're clapping. It's like they're trying to be sarcastic a little. It looks like they're sarcastically just clapping. Yeah. We'll go to the freaking castle. Blah blah blah. Yeah, I'll meet you there in the next episode, because we are gonna stop here today, guys. We took out the dude who had that prophecy. That, you know, he was going to end the world because of Auriel and whatnot. And we're in the next episode, we're gonna go kick some vampire booty. But not Serana's booty, because she's actually... So, yeah. She's, like, looking at me like, yeah, we're going to have to kill my dad. But anyway, guys, if you liked today's episode, please give it a big old thumbs up. Comment down below. Oh, I forgot the comment question of the day. Comment question of the day is, what is your favorite drink and why? Mine is water because it's delicious. So, comment that down below. What's your favorite drink? And if you're not already subscribed, guys, please hit that subscribe button. I would really appreciate it. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace out.